Also, any kink organization that I've ever been a part of, there has always been rules about everyone has to be at least 18 or older to join any of our events, to come to our munches, no matter how casual your interest might be. It's always, that's great, please come back when you're 18. And in some cases, it's actually been 19 and older. There was SM Odyssey, there's still SM Odyssey in the South Bay. They're not as much of a presence as they used to be, but their rule was 19 and older to avoid things like a student ever meeting their teacher, like an actual high school student meeting their teacher at an event. But so we do what we can, and we really don't encourage minors in kink. There's a certain amount of grooming that seems like it would be obvious, especially between, like, the, you know, if you're getting into BDSM, the dominant submissive, you know, a younger submissive seems like, oh, that's great, I can group. But we really frown on that. And anybody who's playing ethically is not doing that sort of thing. And so my thing when I encounter minors in kink is, first of all, that's great that you're interested. Please come back when you're 18. Here are some books to read. Because I'm actually not opposed to giving them material to read. I think education is so incredibly key. Because how can you know about how to interact with a kink community that you might be interested in if you have no concept of what any of this means? And so there are some great books, there are some great resources, and so I try to use everything as a teaching moment. But so I think the organized kink community is part of what protects minors from the abuse that is so, that can so easily be a huge part of that.